Work in the streets and colonized in the sheets is a phrase that the alt-right uses, but also the alt-left use. Seemingly
to
in their own lives.
Describe themselves?
Yes. This isn't a small thing either. This is going on for quite a while, it seems, and I thought I'd just put it all together, because no one seems to talk about it as much as they should, in my opinion. So,
no one has been noting the ethnic breakup of woke activists on the streets quite as diligently as Callum has.
It seems the more you hate white people, the more you want to have sex with white men.
This is that Stone Cart Toss comic come to life.
Yeah, sincerely. I'm not even kidding. A genuine argument here that the more racist you are, the more you want to have sex with other races. Seems to be a trend.
It does happen.
Especially among the alt left there. So we'll start off by promoting something, which is why feminist immigration policy will save the West. Did everyone get a girlfriend, I guess? Even the alt-left. So there you are.
No.
Well, they get a boyfriend.
They're very dysgenic.
But there's very much a gender
maybe
divide
a boyfriend
between the alt-right and the alt-left, I find. At least through the examples going
on.
Well, the alt-right is a very male sphere, and the alt-left is a very female sphere.
Explains all of the homosexuals.
It certainly does, and we'll get to one of them later. But moving on. We'll start off with what most people are probably familiar with, which is the alt-right quite love Asians. And there have been a lot of articles, media,
many
about
such
this.
Cases.
Dan,
for instance,
is he all right?
He's close enough.
All right, has an Asian girlfriend?
Maybe, I don't know.
What else could be going on? But there you are. So this is the New York Times, who decided to write about dating advice. I suppose if you're a racist, find yourself an Asian girlfriend. No, they write the white supremacists of the far right have a yellow fever. Real starting line there.
This sounds like it could come from alt-right infighting that I've seen happen before.
I'm tired of seeing it, not calling it out. Anyway, they say an Asian woman fetish, people who don't know what that is. So Andrew Anglin, the founder of the neo-Nazi website The Daily Stormer, once posted a video of himself with a Filipina he called my jailbait girlfriend. The young couple...
That's a really dodgy phrase to use.
Filipinas for you. The young couple flirting as they sauntered through the mega mall in the Philippines. Richard Spencer, a white nationalist, had a series of Asian American women he dated, according to his ex-girlfriends. Spencer insists that this all happened before he embraced white nationalism.
Before I was racist, guys, I swear.
Now I won't do it anymore. He's
holding himself back.
I had to see what all the fuss was about.
Said twitching in the corner.
Said Spencer in an interview. Didn't happen. So the New York Times then go on to denounce race mixing. For some reason, which is unusual for them, but they don't like it when people who are on the, as they put it, the right, have girlfriends who are of a different race. Okay. They go on to say that it's all a myth and you shouldn't date Asian women. Certified New York Times opinion. Firstly, because they're not real good. The modern minority
wait,
myth.
I know why. I know why they... John, can you scroll up? Who wrote this article? Audria Lim. Oh, okay. I don't know if that sounds like a possibly...
she's an Asian.
Asian name. Okay. Because I have seen one thing that might motivate this kind of thing, which is some insufferable European women terrified that European men might decide that they can just go off and get an Asian girlfriend and then they're left 35, 40 eggless.
Maybe. She may be... In fact, second generation American.
There was a clip going around on Twitter of what's his name, JF. I think that guy talking about the threat of the Asian poontang to the European woman.
The real threat to the white race is, yes, indeed, Asians. He's not wrong. But there you are. There's a lady in question. I think John's just slowed up there, but there we are. But no, the reason she argues that you shouldn't date Asians is because they're not model minorities. In fact, they're just as likely to commit crime as anyone else, which.
Looking at the statistics, they're about slightly less likely to commit crimes than white people.
The New York Times have told me different. The second myth is that Asian women are subservient and hypersexual, which is compared to Western women, of course, presumably.
Maybe this... You said this is like Asian dating. Maybe this is her dating profile that she's just put
on
the New York
Times.
Saying
I'm not sexual and I also am not subservient in any way, which...
I'm insufferable and will never put out at all. Date me, please.
Not a very convincing argument. Asian women, particularly the Japanese she talks about, they're just as feminist as Western women. Trust me, don't go and talk to them and find out. Don't do that.
And I've not been to Japan. I don't even know if I've... Have I met a Japanese person in real life? I don't know.
You don't know if they're real.
That's not what I'm saying. I've played plenty
is
of
Japan
their.
Is Japan real?
I've played plenty of their video right games, there? So I assume they're real.
I don't know. It seems like more far right.
I've
propaganda.
Played Nintendo before. Japan must be real.
I love
Nintendo
the idea.
Exists.
That's a great idea, though. If you've never met like a little Chinese fella, how do you know China's real?
I've met plenty of Chinese people.
Little Chinese fellas. Anyway, moving on. But Vice News also a piece complaining about all this. Specifically, this video, they complain that Jared Taylor speaks fluent Japanese to a Japanese news crew.
He grew up there.
I know, but it's complaint is like, oh, God, look at him integrating. That's a weird one. But they argue that it's horrible because he says in an interview with a Japanese news crew in that fake country of Japan that Asians have higher IQs than whites, which they are sitting there just completely boggled that he might say that the white race is, you know, not as good as the IQ field as the Asians.
And statistically, the East Asians, specifically Japan and South Korea, Singapore, they do statistically have higher IQs. I wouldn't trust some of the data coming out of China or North Korea, but those ones I can trust well enough.
Like 250 IQ average, North Korea. What's your problem?
I mean, makes sense to me.
Yeah. Anyway, but the point isn't to talk about IQ. It's to talk about the fact this has been documented for a while in, let's say, leftist circles. They're like, oh, the right. White race. Yeah, right. Look at that Filipino wife there. And which is a weird thing for them to sit around when they're like, yeah, I don't mind race mixing, but the white race doing it. It's like, okay, only a certain type of white race. Anyway, but the old left have a different meme. And this is the meme.
Yeah.
Black feminists online. These white men are dangerous. Black feminists in real life. Come here.
I mean,
give me a saw that.
She's not black, but that's basically AOC in the right picture.
Before we even get to her.
Although, I have to admit, this is somewhat of an unrepresentative meme, if only because this is supposed to be some kind of chaddish Prince Charming type. And the ones getting with the leftist activists tend not to be Chad Prince Charming types.
It's a very good market if you're an average guy to get with a brown woman who hates white people. It's pretty easy, it seems.
Yeah.
I imagine it's
if
vice versa.
If you're willing to hand over your balls in a nice little jar for her to keep on the mantelpiece, then, you know,
I imagine it's vice versa for the Asians, where it's like, you know, if you're a mid-Asian, you could probably get a nice white supremacist, nice and easy. Don't worry about it. We'll go to the next link here, because, well, this meme has been known for a long time. You can see it here with Ash Sarkar. Many such cases. What white people can do next. There's a lovely stream about dear white people and the privilege test.
Wait,
is
that her husband?
I don't know, but people are saying that this is her boyfriend. I'm taking it on word here. It
mate,
might not be.
Mate, you could do better.
Moving on. We'll go to the next one. Because this meme has been known for a long time. See Sean Head posting here. I hate white people, GF. White BF. Not wrong, Shu. Correct, in fact.
I didn't know that I could just make memes with stick figures.
What do you think? You had to draw Wojax?
Yeah.
No. It turns out stick figures are back in the game. We'll get the next link, because there is obviously more and more. You can see here, Chris Rose posting. I've only just realized that name I can't pronounce. Martha's mum from Doctor Who.
Adjo Ando.
Yeah, the lady from Doctor Who there.
It sounds like some galactic system in Star Wars, to be honest.
Yeah, is anti-white in the streets, but pro-white in the sheets. And we'll go forward, because there's more of that. Because you may remember, of course, she gave a speech on the coronation. As you can see here.
Oh, yes.
Discussed on Headliners, which she discussed. I don't know if you can hit play there real quick just to get the, I think it's the screenshot I was hoping for. There we are. So you can see Martha's mum there saying that the balcony was terribly white and the lady next to her looking on with disgust.
Perfect pause game there. The face that she's pulling and that woman as well.
Yeah. Which
sums it up, really.
I mean, true. But yet another anti-white individual publicly when privately is like, yeah, come on, give us some of that. I presume that's how these women talk. Let's move on. Let's go to the next one. Sorry, 30 more. AOC, someone who any day of the week will be tweeting something about white supremacy and how it runs America.
Why white people are evil.
It could be there are white supremacists. You want to give this a scroll, John, actually, because it goes on and on.
It will go on forever.
Yeah, you know, they're white supremacists hiding in the streets. They're also hiding in your sheets, it turns out. Because although AOC is deadly concerned that the white people just are out to kill people of color every day and are also running the entire country.
She does not suspect her own husband.
No, her own husband is, okay. He's a...
one of the good ones.
He's one of the good ones, as you can see here. Representative AOC and her husband pictured here. a local black man, I'm sure.
Sorry, his face paints a picture in that.
She's not the only squad member. Ilhan Omar, remember, there was a lot of hoo-ha about who she was actually married to, and then a whole of hoo-ha about how it was clearly a scam.
She's going out with short-haired Moldbug, by the looks of it.
So short-haired Moldbug over here has begun... It's on point.
He finally had a haircut.
Yeah, so short-haired Moldbug has decided to take one for the team, and Ilhan Omar over here. So that's two squad members down. So that's 50%.
So we've got two more to go, right?
50% of the squad are dating white men. They rally about how white men need to leave everything, all public life, when they're talking.
Okay, let's try. Can we get 3 for 3?
No. The other two, I have been unable to obtain their spousal records, but I'm sure it won't be too long until we find out.
But one day he'll crack the code.
They'll slip up, but they'll also be sucking white D. Anyway, moving on to Kamala Harris, because the diversity hires, all doing it. They're all doing it too. Kamala Harris here, famously hired to be a diversity hire, and that was it. You may remember the BBC actually ran an advertisement in the UK to educate us Brits about who is Kamala Harris, because none of us knew, and totally everyone in America knew.
See, I thought the problem with the elites is that they were all getting together in parties and diddling kids. It turns out what they're actually doing is getting together and swapping white boyfriends.
Well, at least some of them. But the reason I brought up that point about the BBC is, you may remember, I don't know if you saw it, they did bring up an image. I remember a screenshot I put on Twitter where they put a picture of Kamala Harris and then an animation of brown, tick.
I remember that.
Woman, tick.
I remember that.
Vice president, question mark.
Now, tick.
Yeah, so there you are. Literally, she was only hired for diversity. And in her own room, she does not practice what she preaches, which is funny.
I mean, that looks like it would be quite a diverse bedroom to me.
Speaking of the White House, should we go to the other diversity hire in the White House? There we are. This is the person who lies.
Even the lesbians aren't immune.
Even the lesbians. So you have here the lesbian spokesman for the White House, just another diversity hire, who decided to marry a white woman for some reason.
I'm going to make a wild guess here. Spence. Say, Supreme Court diversity hire.
Should we go to it? Should we have a look?
All right, let's
come
take a look.
On. Supreme Court diversity hire. Who are you? Oh, it's a white guy.
There you go.
So that's 3 for 3.
Do you reckon she was getting home ranting about the affirmative action decision? And he's there just like, babe.
You're a diversity hire to me.
You were purely by merit, okay?
I'm sure she was. Anyway, moving on, because that's 3 for 3. Literally all three of the prominent diversity hires for the White House, same thing. Don Limon. Also did the same thing. It's another man who props up the ideology that won't stop whining about how white people are the devil.
What does he do now? He doesn't work for CNN anymore. What does he do?
He sues CNN, I believe. That's his full-time job now.
What he's doing
at the moment? He'll get a lot of money if he wins. He'll never have to work another day in his life.
Oh, all right.
So there we are. If you're looking for work, kids, if you want to know what you want to be when you grow up, sue CNN. There we are. Lori Lightfoot.
Before you decide.
Lori Lightfoot, you may remember this. Talking here about how she won't give interviews to white journalists ever again. So she doesn't do interviews with whiteies. She doesn't talk to whiteies. She doesn't know any whiteies, except from her wife, who is a whitey.
I didn't know Lori Lightfoot was a lesbian as well.
Yeah. One of those lesbians that only dates white people for some reason. Moving forward, because I also found a few randoms. I mean, there's this lady here, Brittina James, MD, a Chicago-based physician, activist, black feminist, and anti-racist scholar. Got her own website here.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty significant following of other people who talk about how they hate white people and whiteness has got to go. Do you want to guess?
White boyfriend?
Yeah, white BF here.
Oh, white husband.
There we are, white husband, in fact. With anti-white GF. Funny that. A lot of people keep figuring this out, and I'm a bit weirded out that there aren't a bunch of media pieces being like, that's why you're all the people on our side, not toeing the line in the bedroom. The white supremacy of the bedroom. I can see the article now from Salon.com, just talking about those ladies who are letting the side down. Because as I pointed out, this does seem to be a gender divide as well, which is it's all the hating white people girls and all the loving white people boys out there.
They get together.
That would solve one thing.
And then you can create the colorblind society together.
You actually want that. You can. There's one route, doesn't it? I mean, this person pointed out, these women all suck the D of a white man, and then in the same breath say we need to end white supremacy. Now, they did include a gay man in that lineup of women. Pete Buttigieg over there.
Yeah.
I mean, he probably does. So,
as far as I'm aware, his husband is white, so this is true.
Should we take a quick look about what all those people hate as well, when they honestly talk about whiteness has got to go in the white world?
Oh, yes, I saw this earlier on today.
There's a local leftist who has come to tell us unspeakable levels of whiteness on the New York subway.
No one's being robbed, no one's being mugged or stabbed or assaulted.
Should we have a listen?
Oh, yep.
Let's take a look at this horror of the New World.
It's entering season in New York.
Yeah, horrific, horrific.
Absolutely disgusting lack of crime in this video.
I cannot live like that, said AOC. She went and got a white husband. Anyway, moving on. Because, of course, it does go the other way as well. Over the weekend, you may have noticed there was a fun time over on the Fresh and Fit podcast. Oh,
you've not included my favorite screenshot from this one. Oh, or have you?
I've not just added the screenshot.
Oh, so, no. Oh, so, yes, I think I know what no, might be no, coming up didn't. Next.
Oh, yes, I did. So this, for people listening, is a happy Nick Fuentes with a happy...
A very happy-looking Nick Fuentes, in fact.
Young black lady with her tits out to the left hand, which, there we are. Nick went on Fresh and Fit, and, well, we'll get the next image, and we'll see that, I suppose, in which here's the huge lineup of everyone that was on that show, in particular.
Nick finally lost his virginity. Good on you, mate.
It was all black women with the tits out, and,
and Nick their asses out.
Yeah, that too. So there you are. Shoving into each other. Anyway, so they went on the show, and how do you think it went? Because, of course, they were all like, ooh, he's racist.
Well, yeah, it's the stone toss meme, again, obviously.
So they actually did it. Let's play what happened, which is they asked him to say the dreaded word. Yeah, presumably in the bedroom, too. Let's play that.
Well, you can say it.
Say it. Come on, man. I want you to say it.
For real. What's
you want me to say it?
Yes.
Yeah. Is anyone going to hit it?
Mine is too. I'm hoping that's coming
through. Yeah, no. Come on, man. What you get?
Now my audio is gone. Yes. Let's hope it's just us. I'm sure it is just us. Kind of annoying. It's kind of a funny clip.
Yeah. So if the audio was messing up for you watching from home, I'm sure it wasn't. But if it was, as you can imagine, they were all goading him into saying a particular word, which we're not allowed to say.
He said the word.
And then they all cheered for him.
They all went, ooh. Which
they all went, ooh.
In fact, let's play this next clip, because someone did a zoom in on a particular lady next to him and her face. Let's play that one.
You want me to say it?
Yes!
I didn't notice that.
For some reason, she was quite enticed by that. So there we are. There was a response to the ladies on the show, which was quite funny, which I think we'll also enjoy because we'll go to the next link. We can see here one of the ladies giving him a little kiss on the cheek.
Little peck.
He does the Allahu Akbar signal. Someone responding, black women, what are y'all doing? Well, having fun, my friend, because if here's the next link, we can see there were a lot of responses to her on Instagram. Because, of course, on the right, we could see her in her daily life. Black Lives Matter, I stand for George Floyd, fist in the air.
Can I just point out, we were talking about, you know, racial mixing. The amount of overtly racist accounts that I've seen recently, either praising Clarence Thomas or, as we see here, using him as a profile picture, is pretty fantastic.
It's a wild world, the United States. And
he's
we'll click
an official
on that.
Member of the tribe.
We'll click on that left image so we can show people what I'm speaking of in regards to the Instagram responses. As you can see, her there having fun with Nick and her saying, you know, I appreciate inviting me on the show. Never thought you'd be loving a black woman, would you, Nick? Blah, blah, blah. And the first response is, he's a white supremacist. You have a black son. What the F is wrong with you?
Did people forget that, like, earlier on this year, late last year, he was in full support of Kanye 2024?
Obviously.
I mean, people got short memories.
But I also just love the idea. It's like, no, you can't.
No, you egged him on to say the N-word. No. I did see...
You're making the racist not racist. No.
I don't know if you've got it, but there was one particular woman, a black woman. I forget what her name is. She's appeared on iHypocrite before, but she was retweeting it and just saying, yeah, guess what? It's like I've always been saying, these people don't actually care about you using the word. It's just a joke to them. They just like it as an excuse to be able to get angry at white people for saying it.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, it's obviously the truth.
And that's my real point, really. If we're the last one here, just to make it, which is that, well, racism is kind of a meme in the West, and it has been for a long time. I mean, I suppose amongst the elder generations, you might remember sometime, I'm told, in the distant past, it was racismus, and it was awful, and the thunder did crackle, and blah, blah, blah. You know, etc.
Everything was bad, everything was evil, yeah.
But I mean, my generation, I'm sure you too. I mean, racism is just a joke. Like, it literally is just a meme people share. It's something people bond over more than anything else in the modern world.
Being racist can be quite funny.
In fact, it'll make you make out with black ladies or white men, or
it actually brings all of the races together.
Or Asians.
John, just I wanted to make sure this is quote tweeting. Just click on it. I just want to make sure if it's the image that I was thinking of.
I think it is. Is it Nick here?
Oh no, sorry. It was the one that we looked at earlier. There is the really funny one of him just copying a look. Overtly, right on camera. I mean, to be fair, she was sat next to him the whole time, just with her tits out. So it's not that surprising that he did.
Well,
but it's still funny to have a...
wait. The line meme. Go back to the line meme. Because it's so stupid.
Look at him. He's strong, stance, facing the world, not hiding his penis.
There we are. Penis to the world. So you know. Right. Anyway, but the point being, I mean, outside the West, racism is something that's still kind of serious. Whereas in the West, it is just comical at this point. And I just love how you have, of course, the anti-white GF over there screeching about how the world needs to be destroyed because of the racism in the West. But at the same time, obviously, the opposite is the case. And there we have it. A lesson for you all. Never ask a racist about his wife and never ask an anti-racist about her husband. If you appreciated that segment from the podcast of the Lotus Eaters, you can go to lotuseaters.com to get access to all the premium contents on the site, such as the Epoch series, this episode on Thomas Beckett. If you'd like to find out what else is being put out, you can follow on Getter at lotuseaters_com on Getter. Thank you and goodbye.